If he just goes f5, what am I going to do? Well, I'd just take the pawn, wouldn't I? I'll just grab on e5 and hope for the best. I wonder if he might just give up that b-pawn to try and... I wonder if he... Or maybe he just played b6, then followed by bishop a3. If he played b6, that's kind of annoying. I might have to just play knight c7 to it. And then takes, takes. That's not very attractive, really. Could I let him have the exchange? B6. Okay, he's gone for the obvious pawn. Well, there's only one move, so I might as well make it. Oh shit, rook. Rook d8. Well, the knight's got to go to c7 if he does that. So there's only one move, knight c7, I think. Getting to the stage where we need to make auto moves, just in case. I'm not expecting him to do that, by the way, but just in case he does. Might as well play queen b6 check now, maybe. Bishop blocks, bishop c5. Takes, takes. Might be getting out of that. Yeah, queen b6 check. Need to make a move. Need to play fairly quickly. Bishop, queen, bishop c5 is what I was thinking of. Don't think there's anything too nasty. Queen b6 check, won a rook. No, I missed that one. So he can do much else apart from take the bishop, can he? bishop takes bishop, queen takes bishop, then maybe knight somewhere. Maybe not. It's on a fairly good square. Maybe he played knight. No. Well, what's he gonna do after that? I mean, he could play 97. Okay, he's played that. So 96 now. And f5, you know, it can just hop to g5. And f6 seems the obvious move. I don't know, maybe I can try and start pushing pawns soon. I think knight versus bishop would be, well, usually with the queens on the board, you know, you want queen and knight rather than queen and bishop. And I don't see anything to dissuade me of that here. Doesn't appear to be too many horrendous things to bishop b7. What can he do? You know, there's lots of discovered stuff before if I did that. So bishop b7. Knight somewhere. Bishop takes bishop, queen takes bishop, and that's gotta be it. At least level, surely. Depending on where his knight, I suppose if he went to d8, but then, you know, I could just take his knight and that defends the bishop, so that doesn't work. I wonder if he might just play f5. Then knight g5. Yeah, that's not very good, is it? Because then I do play bishop b7, and that's winning a piece, isn't it? So, yeah, I don't think he's played this as well as he could have done. I don't think the whole idea with rook d8 was the best plan for him, actually. I think he should have played b6, sorry, b3 even, and tried to stick the rook bishop on a3. I was more worried about that at the time. Few things. I mean, I could look to play knight d4 as well, but then I do like him after that. Maybe takes bishop c6, queen takes pawn check. Well, yeah, I think that line looks a bit better for him. So lines with bishop b7. Then at least I get the knight against the bishop. Just shoving pawns. Bishop b7. Bishop b7 knight. Can he play knight e7? Well, no, he can't, because I'll take. No, yeah. Okay, I'm just going to play bishop b7. I think. Hopefully, there's nothing terrible here. I mean, he can play f5 now. very likely I'll lose on time here. Or, if not, probably I probably won't lose on time, but I can lose as a result of the time, if you know what I mean. Because I'm having to play rather quickly here. I must say, I thought Tim did play the opening very well. Oh, hang on. No, thank goodness that knight d8 doesn't work, as I said before. You know, knight takes d8 saves me. Otherwise, you know, you would be threatening knight takes f7 check. Which would win a pawn. Possibly, but it doesn't. So I'm looking at bishop takes c6, bishop takes c6 in most lines. Okay, it's bloody f5, wow. So just still bishop takes c6? Bishop takes c6, pawn takes e6, so that wins a piece for me. So he's got a recapture on c6, hasn't he? And then I could go knight d4, which seems quite good. Does that win a piece? Bishop takes c6. Well, I'm just going to play it. I haven't got time to be pontificating.